We will start with graph coloring problem. Graph coloring problem. Okay. So what is the problem? That is, you have to, there are a graph is given like this way. Suppose 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay. You have to color each node. There are 5 nodes, so you have to color each node in such a way that no two adjacent node will have the same color. Suppose if it is blue, 5 and 2 cannot be blue. Okay, so given that, suppose 3 color is been given. Suppose R, red, green, blue. So how could you color this graph? Okay. So take any color. Let us say I take this red. So if it is red, 2 will be what? It cannot be red, because the graph coloring says that no two adjacent node will be of same color. So it may be, suppose, green or blue. Let us say it is green. Now let us consider the 3. Since it is adjacent to 2, so, and 2 is green, so I can take red. Okay, now let us say 4. Since it is red, so it will cannot be red, so it will be green. Now let us say about 5. Now what will be the 5? See, 1 is adjacent to 5, 4 is adjacent to 5, but 1 is red, 4 is green. So what will be 5? There is no option left. And also see, adjacent of 5, another adjacent is 2, it is red, it is green. 5 adjacent to 3, it is red. So there is only one possible, that it will be blue. Okay, so this is one solution. You can take, instead of red, if you start with green, then I can, this can be another option is available. So this can be another option. So there are many possible option can be taken. So there are two things in this graph coloring problem. So one is called, number one, m coloring decision problem. What is m coloring decision problem? It means whether the graph can be colored or not. Okay, so m coloring decision problem means whether the graph can be colored or not. Okay, so this is m coloring decision problem. Another, there is a problem from this graph coloring problem, is m coloring optimization problem. M coloring optimization problem. Okay, so what is m coloring optimization problem? It is minimum how many color needed, that is minimum how many color is needed to color all the nodes. So minimum how many color needed. Okay, so you see that here minimum 3 color is needed in this, in our example. Okay, now let us take another example. Say, suppose I take 1, 2, 3, and 4, and it is connected like this way. Okay, so let us draw state space tree of this particular graph. So m is 3 is given, and color is given red, green, and blue. Okay, so let us start with one node. Okay, and if you start with one node, so what are the possible solution you can draw? So it can be red, it can be green, it can be blue. Okay, so again from red, so this 3 can be drawn, red, green, blue, again red, green, blue, red, green, blue. Okay, so again from this node, again 3 options can be drawn. Okay, so you can fill this option. Also from this node, again three options can be drawn. Okay, so what you have to find that how many root level, suppose your root level is one, so how many nodes can be generated. So root level, there is only one node. In this second level, there is three. In this third level, that is 3 into 3. Okay, this is so this is the root node, this is the first level, this is the second level. Okay, 3 into 3, and this is the third level. I get 3 3 3. So this is 1, this is 3, this is 3 into 3, 3 1 2 3 into 3. Next, for each there is 3, so 3 into 3 into 3. Okay, and for this last node we are getting 3 into 3 into 3 into 3. So if you calculate this, the formula we will get 3 to the power 4 plus 1 minus 1 by 3 minus 1, that is 3 to the power 4 plus 1 minus 1 by 2. Okay, so it is nearly equal to 3 to the power n plus 1, where n is the number of nodes. So what are, how many combinations can be happen? It is c to the power n plus 1. Okay, so we see that this graph coloring problem is nothing but some exponential time taking problem. Okay, exponential time taking problem, because it is some constant to the power n, but this suppose constant to the power n means 2 to the power n. So this is exponential time taking problem. Okay, so this is a state space tree. So now we will see that where do we use this graph color. Okay, so in previous days when printing is not so much popular, or you can say that printing is not nowadays like offset printing or something like that, in those days if you want to color a particular country, color suppose you want to color any area, then that was is used. So let us consider one figure like this way. So this is one area. Okay, this is another area, this is another area. Okay, this is another area, and finally this is another area. Okay, so suppose this is adjacent countries are there, and we have to find that no two adjacent countries will have the same color. Okay, so this is country number one. Okay, this is country number 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay, now let us draw the graph, adjacency graph. So 1, 1 is connected to 2, 3 and 5. So it is 2, 5, 3. 2 and 3 and 4 is connected. This is connected 2, 3. 2, 5 is also connected. Okay, and there is another 4, 4. These are all connected. Okay, so in this case how it could be done. So this is the graph. Okay, so adjacency is the graph, and you have to color this particular node with minimum number of colors. So in this case graph coloring problem can be used. Okay, you can solve it yourself, but this is the main problem. This is the case where you can apply the graph coloring problem. Okay, so the problem is that map where adjacent area are not same color. Okay, so this is the problem, and from this map we will first you draw the corresponding graph and you do the graph coloring problem, and you can ultimately draw it. Okay.